Well, another in California woman will now spend the next year and a half behind bars. That's because she faked her own kidnapping.
That's right. And Sherri Papini's actually sentence brings to a close a nearly six-year saga that made national headlines. Dennis Shanahan has more.
It was a case that began on the back roads of Shasta County and went on to make national news. Sherri Papini, a 34-year-old mother of two, disappeared in November 2016 while jogging near her Redding home. While search parties gathered and detectives looked for leads, Sherri's husband Keith begged for her safe return.
Bring her home. Bring her home. Just bring her home.
After three agonizing weeks, on Thanksgiving Day, the story took a joyful turn.
We are ecstatic to report that Sherri Papini has been located and has been reunited with her family on this day.
But there was a dark side to this good news. Papini was found bruised, branded, and bound with restraints 140 miles from home along Interstate 5 in Yolo County. She claimed she had been kidnapped by two women. The case went quiet until early last month when Papini was arrested and charged with lying to federal agents and defrauding the state's victims compensation board of $30,000. Prosecutors said she made up the abduction story and actually left voluntarily to spend time with an ex-boyfriend in Southern California. Now, newly filed federal court documents reveal Papini admits to making up the abduction story. She has reached a plea deal. According to the agreement, she will plead guilty to lying to a federal officer and mail fraud. The fraud charge stems from her requests to receive victims' compensation. In a written statement released by her attorney, Papini states, "I am deeply ashamed of myself for my behavior and so very sorry for the pain I've caused my family, my friends, all the good people who needlessly suffered because of my story, and those who worked so hard to try to help me. I will work the rest of my life to make amends for what I have done."
If she's going to be candid with them, they're going to get a minute-by-minute bird's-eye view, the fly on the wall, so to speak, of everything that happened throughout that entire period. And there's probably some others that knew what they were doing was wrong, and they're probably going to grab them up with this as well.
Attorney Mark Reichel was not involved in Papini's case, but he followed it closely.
This is a real successful early blow by her defense attorney, Mr. Portnova, and I'll tell you why. Prevailing on a defense in this case would have been really difficult. I think they realized that right away and took that off of our discussion. Now, look, we're not going to say not guilty by reason of insanity, which is something so difficult to prevail on in federal court.